everybody, this is Matamata here once again with more vanilla Minecraft, and this episode you're actually going to get a very super exclusive sneak peek at what I actually do when I'm not recording, and it's going to be very, very, very exciting because, as you all know, oh, by the way, this is my mineshaft, or at least it's the entrance to it. This is actually a pretty effective squid farm, even though I don't really need squid. Hey, whatever, I'll just take what I can get. So I use that as a squid farm sometimes, but this is where my mineshaft is. I'm not even sure if I've told anyone. I almost have 1,000, and I don't know what I'm going to do once I hit 1,000, because as you can probably tell from my first subscriber quote-unquote special, which was just me sitting in a chair talking about stuff, it wasn't really that much. It was just me sitting in a chair talking about stuff. But this new special, I assure you, will be something of more importance. I have a lot of old worlds. Now, I don't have old worlds. Like, Etho has the worlds that he literally, like, his first world he ever had. And I don't even have close to that. I was a freaking idiot when I was 12, so I deleted pretty much all of my first 6 month worlds and without even thinking twice. Like, I used to just go like, this world's getting uninteresting, let's delete it, because my... Whoa! Hello. You were exactly what I was looking for. Tell me you're 8. Yes, you are 8. I love you. I love it when you're 8. But anyway, I was an idiot and I used to delete a lot of the things that I had, and basically I wouldn't even think twice about deleting a world. I'd be like, well, I'm not too interested in this, because my sort of slight OCD, I don't technically have OCD, I know some people get really, well, I haven't been tested for it at least, but I used to be really, really strict about only having like 5 worlds at once so that I wouldn't get the slider on the like the edge of it, or that would really bug me. So I would basically delete worlds so I would only have like 4 at once or something. So basically whenever I get, you know, slightly uninterested in a world, I would delete it, and I wouldn't even think twice. Even if I was going to, like, even if I was very, okay, let me just mine these. This is fortune, right? Okay. This is terrible so far. Seriously? Okay, 17. I guess that's good. That could have got me, like, 32, though. That's half of what I could have got from that. That's still pretty good. But I used to delete my old worlds a lot, and I really, really regret doing that now, because I only have... The only worlds that I have left are pretty much at the very end of 1.8, which I started playing at the beginning of. So... yeah, delete a lot of them. I have as much as I can remember from all of them in a Word document, but what I'm, or in a notepad, just so that I don't completely and entirely forget what I used to be like when I played this game. But for my special, I'm probably going to be talking about some things while I'm actually playing through some of my old worlds and showcasing how much of a noob I used to be at this game. But this is really off topic. So, to the Witherscout Farm. Okay, don't quote me on this, but I think this is gonna be enough stone slabs. I don't know, though. It should be, because if it's not, I don't even understand what this is anymore. So, what I'm gonna go about doing is first making this safer for me to traverse. I also brought my backup baked potatoes. They are backup. You know, that's why they're called backup baked potatoes, because, well... if I run out of food, then I won't exactly have any food, and that will be really bad. However, these intersections, the reason why I'm going to put the half slabs up like this is simply because these intersections allow more space for wither skeletons to spawn, which is something that not many people know, and most people know it, do know it because of Etho. That's the reason why I know it, at least, because he taught us all, he taught me at least, that these intersections have extra spawning areas for wither skeletons. And if you're some... oh, crap. If you're somebody who doesn't know why one would ever wither skeleton farm, you must either be a noob or you just don't know somehow. And the reason why one would do this is for wither skeleton heads. Wither skeleton heads can construct the wither, which can construct a beacon, which can construct awesome potion effects that you have constantly if you have enough iron blocks or gold blocks or diamond blocks or emerald blocks to support it. And I don't know why I'm explaining this, because most people probably already know this, but that's... good. My inventory's already filled up. I need to make a chest to put these stone slabs in, or else I'm gonna be in trouble, and I'm gonna have nowhere to put these. Oh, hi. Okay, first things first. Chest. I'm going to put it over... why not put it over here? However, I think the blaze spawner... now, if I'm not next to it, it shouldn't screw up any of the spawning, because... It doesn't have a very wide range. I was concerned for a minute that the blaze spawner would sort of screw up the spawning of the wither skeleton farm, but it won't. It won't. I'm just gonna put all those in there. Apparently there are a crap ton of blazes. Now, whenever you see blazes, that normally means that wither skeletons could have also... So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So there's an extra layer of them right here. So it's 13 by 13 is the area that these can spawn in. So it's basically a 4 by 4 little thingamajigger out here that is extra that the wither skeletons can spawn in, because it's a 13 by 13 square. So I'm going to go ahead and fill that in. However, what I mean by intersections is only the intersections that do not have a roof. Like these ones right here. These intersections, these are bad. Do not do this on these intersections. It will not work. The only spaces that wither skeletons, those guys right there, can actually spawn in on these intersections with roofs are the actual part that's nether brick. So basically building around it will be completely and utterly pointless. Hey, where'd you come from, dude? These guys' AI seems a little off. I don't know what it is about them, but they don't really seem to aggro on you very easily. Which, I mean, is a good thing, because... Ooh, crap. Oh, crap! I just heard that, too. I just heard a zombie pigman get hit, and I thought it was me that hit it, and, I would have probably been dead for eternity there, if that is what would have happened. So, from now on, I'm just going to put these things. The only time that I'll ever really put them up here is when it's a real intersection that I can cover up like that, and it'll do me some good, because if I do it like this, this is the reason why I brought slabs. I don't really have to light anything up. It just... makes them not spawn, because if you know how the mob spawning works, it's basically mobs cannot spawn on either glass, basically any block that is not opaque, or any block that isn't a full block that mobs cannot spawn on. There. I'm also going to cover up this lava source. Whoa! Okay, seriously, whoever is doing that really needs to stop, because it's nerve-wracking the crap out of me. What is your problem? Where did this come from? I got one somehow. Okay, I have a wither skeleton skull. I don't know how long I've had that in my inventory, but whoever noticed that was probably screaming at their screen. Is it you? Is it you, sir? No, it is not you, evidently. Now, once I create multiple of these intersections where I just do my previous strategy, this should be actually going really, really well. And as you can see, this one does not have a ceiling either, so I'm going to do the thing I did on the last one. This is ridiculous! I've barely even done anything, and look at how many of them are spawning. I'm gonna have a wither soon, and then I'm gonna be able to mine amazingly, and everything's just gonna be all dandy and awesome. I've never used the words dandy and awesome, you know, sequentially like that, and I don't think I'm ever going to ever again. By the way, if you hear that strange inhuman screeching sound in the background, don't worry about that. That's actually just a freaking gigantic plant rubbing against the window in another room. So, yeah, don't worry about that. That's nothing. Oh. Oh, I wasn't expecting you to act. Yes! This is ridiculous! This is ridiculously ridiculous. This never goes this well. How am I already one skill away from fighting the Wither? That concerns me and makes me excited at the same time. The most annoying part is freaking removing these fences. It's infuriating! It takes so long for no reason. Oh, I thought you were after me for a minute, little piggy. I was gonna be super afraid. Look at this. Look at this. I can't even describe the madness that is how many blazes and how many wither skeletons are over here. It's just unexplainable. Unexplainable. It is unexplainable. Yes! Oh, yes. Yes. That went extremely well. Now, all I have to do is get back to my house without dying. That sounds very easy, but in reality, it's probably going to be very difficult now, isn't it? Especially with all these stupid things all over the place trying to kill me. But yeah, super effective Wither Skeleton Farm for only taking, like, 30 minutes to set up at the maximum. So, I was surprised by that. I hope you were surprised by that, because I was. 3 Wither Skeleton Skulls caught on tape in, like, maybe 15 minutes of Wither Skeleton hunting. So that was very good. That was very, very good. I was planning to have to set up like an ender chest or something, but apparently I didn't need to do that. So, back to the house. And of course, what would be a wither battle without a crappy enchanted chest plate? Yes, yes, you heard me. We're going to battle the wither, or at least we're going to try. I doubt we're going to be able to kill it, but it's not like I'm in any sort of shortage of wither skulls. I can pretty much just go out there and run around for like 15 minutes and get more wither skulls. I am very, very, very surprised. They must have made some sort of change to the way that wither skulls are dropped. They probably made the amount of them, or the likelihood that they will drop a lot more from last update or something. I mean, there's no logical explanation for what just happened. Also, don't ask me why I have 4 enchanted wooden pickaxes. It's because I'm cool, nerd. Why not? I'm going to do pants. I'm not gonna wear these all the time, by the way. It's a waste wearing complete like, diamond armor. Like, it's really not worth it, because diamond armor breaks way faster than diamond armor really should break, and it costs a lot of diamonds, obviously, since it's diamond armor, so I'm not gonna be wearing this all the time. This is just a super ultra wither precaution, and I forgot my lapis lazuli. Protection 3, that's good. Yep, that's actually really good. Okay, so now that I have this much armor, Yeah, there really shouldn't be any problem. I just got hit by an arrow and I didn't even do any damage at all. So now all I need to do is brew some health potions, some regen potions, and I think that should actually be it. That's all I really need is healing potions. I do have melons, right? No, I don't have melons. Ooh. No, I don't. That's a problem. For now, I'm just going to put them, like, right here, because I don't really have any other place to put them. I do have glass in here, right? Yep. I'm just going to make a ton of thingy-ma-dukers in here. Yep, thingy-ma-dukers. There we go. 63 bottles should be enough. Now all I need to do, it's very convenient that I have a water source in here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10... of 12. Okay. So now all I need to do is start brewing up some more potions, and I'll be back. So where shall I fight the Wither at? I will probably fight him in my mine shaft or something. Just close him in a little box and hope he doesn't get away. And if he does get away, well, I mean, I can't really do much about that. Oh, hey, look, local brewery. Like, the one enchantment I haven't got, I finally got it. Yeah, they only last for 22 seconds, as opposed to the, holy crap, I should not have done that. They only last for 22 seconds. Wow, that wasn't smart. These should be the only potions that I really have to brew, so I'm just going to go ahead and put these back. Alright. For now, I'm just going to put those in there. Who cares? Let's get this going. And let's die. And all this crap. Okay, so I've made this super long, curly hallway of curves so that if I ever need to retreat from the Wither, it can't really catch up to me through this weird hallway thing, which is attached to my mine. Now, it's not, like, in my mine or anything because... Whoopsie. I'm really surprised that didn't kill me. I need to find a better way to actually get in here. I don't know why I just haven't been, you know, doing this instead of making that perilous jump every single time. Now I need to wait for my freaking health to regen. That's just amazing. And right when I put this Wither Skeleton Skull on the Wither... on the Wither Body thingamajigger, I'm going to move this potion of regeneration down. I'm going to drink this one and this one. I'm going to have this one in my hotbar. I'm going to switch these two out with other potions. And we'll see how it goes. I certainly doubt that this is going to last longer than a minute and 30 seconds. But I'm going to replace my strength potion anyway. Let's eat. Okay, I'm staying perfectly still. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to place... this Wither Skeleton... oh no. Head, right here. I'm going to put this down in here. I'm going to drink both of these. And I'm going to move these down. So, now the Wither is finally activated. And let's fight! Hello! Whoa, you look like you were stuck for a minute. You look like you were certainly stuck. Holy crap, this was easy! Oh my gosh! Okay, well, I didn't expect that at all. I have full health. Was there like a glitch in the system there or something? I don't know how that happened so well. How did that happen so well? I have no idea. I didn't even have to retreat at all. I just went around this corner. Okay, well, that went incredibly well. So, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and, you know, if you liked it, you should like it, or, you know, don't, you know, if you dislike this, you should like it anyway, too, that would be nice, but anyway, I hope you enjoyed, as I've already said, and I hope you come back for next time, so bye.